Good morning. Today's children's sermon is based on Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 6, verses 10 through 20. And in it, Paul talks about putting on armor. Now, armor is special clothing that people wear to protect themselves against swords and arrows. Usually when we think about armor, we think about men and knights fighting. This suit of armor behind me belongs to my husband, Lloyd, and he actually did fight in it. But Paul was talking about a different kind of enemy in the scripture, and the enemy is temptation. And temptation is the desire to do something that we know is wrong, are not good for us, or smart to do. Some examples of temptation would be if you decided to sleep late when you knew that you should be getting ready for school, or you skipped doing your chores to play your video game. Those are instances of giving in to temptation. If you watch old-timey cartoons like Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck, you'll see temptation represented as an angel and a devil sitting on your shoulder, and they're arguing with each other all the time. One of them is urging us to do what's right, while the other one is urging us to do the wrong thing. The fight is a struggle inside of us and not with an outside enemy. And this constant internal struggle leads us into trouble and gets us into sin. And sin is the bad things that we do that make God sad and separate us from God. And Paul is talking about using the words of Jesus as armor to protect us from temptation. Now, John Wesley, the father of Methodism, knew a thing or two about temptation, and he took Jesus' words and boiled them down into three simple rules for us to live by. The first one is do no harm. The second one is do all the good you can. And the third one is stay in love with God. And these rules help us fight off the desire to give in to temptation. When we pray the Lord's Prayer, which is the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, we're asking God not to let us fall into temptation. So let's pray together. Our Father in heaven, let your holy name be known, let your kingdom come, and your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today the bread that we need, and forgive our wrongs as we forgive those who've wronged us. Do not let us fall into temptation, but save us from evil. For yours is the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.